Lord, that I could be bound up by your love, oh God. That there would be so much of your love that would just wrap me up and bind me and keep me. How many of us here this morning just want to be kept? Keep me in the hollow of your hand, no more. Yeah. David referred to that many times, that he's got me in the hollow of his hand. That's this part right here. That's down there. That's the deepest part of my palm, is the hollow of my hand. Amen. That he can hold me. And when the enemy comes in like a flood, his spirit will raise up a standard against the enemy. Why? Because his love is holding me. His love is binding me. Hallelujah. I'm not bound up any longer by the things of the world. I came out from the world. I came out from those things that were holding me back. I can't. Oh, come on. He is the one that ran to me. I was making my way to him, but I was just walking. He was running. Hallelujah. He found me in my sin, and he filled me with his spirit, and he made a new creature out of me. God, let your love shine through me.
Amen.
That his love could shine through us. Hallelujah. God's desire is that you are a lighthouse.
Thank you, Jesus.
I got a humorous story about this Navy captain. And he's driving this brand new state-of-the-art, one of the largest ships ever built. It's a big aircraft carrier, huge. And so he's the pilot of that aircraft carrier. He's standing up on the bridge, and it's in the middle of the night, and it's foggy. And all of a sudden, he sees another boat coming towards him. So he has his radio man send a message. And so the radio man taps out a message and sends it to the ship that's coming ahead. And he said, just tell him he needs to move to the right. This is the captain of the great vessel, so-and-so, whatever it was. You need to move your ship 3 degrees starboard. The guy on the other ship sends back a message to the great captain of this great new ship. No, you need to move 3 degrees starboard. Wait a minute here. Nobody is going to tell this captain what to do. So he tells the radio man, let me see that. And so he gets on there. He said, this is Captain So-and-so. I'm an admiral with the U.S. Navy. I've been with the U.S. Navy for 25 years. You don't tell me what to do. What is your rank, sir? I'm a seaman, first class, sir. Then you move that vessel now 3 degrees starboard. Seaman, first class. Radio's back, no. With all due respect, sir, you move 3 degrees starboard. Oh man, he's furious. He sent the message back, who do you think you are? Don't you understand? I am the top admiral in the Navy. I'm the very top admiral. I can have you court-martialed. Little meager reply comes back. Sir, please move 3 degrees starboard. I'm a lighthouse. So the lighthouse don't move. All it does is send out a light to warn you that there's destruction ahead. Hallelujah. You got to understand, That's all a lighthouse is. It don't move. It just stands firm, and it just sends out a light. You don't want to come this way. There's destruction here. Go that way. Go that way, but don't come this way, because there's destruction here. Can you understand this morning, amen, that the lighthouse shined his light on you? Amen. You were just kind of wandering aimlessly in the fog of this life, and all of a sudden there was a light that shined and said, no, you don't want to go that way. There's nothing but destruction there. If you'll just turn your ship towards this way. Oh, hallelujah. I want somebody to know this morning that the lighthouse has shined his light on me. Amen. There is love that has filled me up my heart. Amen. It's an unending love that has wrapped me up, has made a difference in my life, and it will make a difference in you. Amen. If you'll understand and get a grasp on just how much he loves us.
Amen.
You see, we get all wrapped up in our little world. Oh, we're spiritual folks. I understand that. We are. And you should be spiritual. If you're not, shame on you. Amen. But as spiritual people, amen, we have a desire to do something for God, or at least we should have. Hallelujah. If you don't have a desire to do something for God, amen, something is missing in your life. But his love constrains us. It wraps us up. It binds us to him to such a degree that all we can think about is not what can I do for me today, but what can I do for him today? How many of us, I'm still a hand, but how many of us, I wonder, actually get up in the morning time and the first thing you do is praise God and thank him for his presence and thank him for sparing you and keeping you through another night? And Lord, then all of a sudden you begin to tell him, God, I want to do something for you today. I wonder how many of us do that. How many of us say, I want to do something for you today, God? You have been so precious and done so much for me. Just by loving me, you have done so much in my life. And now my desire is that I could be wrapped up in you. Hallelujah. My desire, oh, come on. My desire is that you could wrap me up in your love, that I could feel your presence. Hallelujah. Oh, I want somebody here this morning to know, amen, without a doubt, you can feel him, that I may know him. Amen. That's what the scripture said, that I may know him, Paul said. I want to really know him. Hallelujah. I don't care what it costs me. I don't care what I have to go through. Oh, you hear me this morning. A lot of folks living for God nowadays, they're just kind of half-heartedly doing it. Lord, I'll live for you if you'll let me continue to be able to do this. Uh-huh. Oh, Lord. That's why he said, come out from among them and touch not their unclean things.
That's it.
Hallelujah. Because there's a way that seemeth right unto a man.
Mm-hmm.
Called religion. What is religion anyway? It is man-made worship. God's not interested in that. He's interested in somebody that'll be so sold out that he can wrap his love around them. Hallelujah. And they will emanate his love. Oh, come on. You know what the word emanate means? It means to reproduce. It means to let it shine out like that lighthouse shined to you. His love needs to shine out from you. It needs to reproduce, amen, in the people around you. They need to be able to feel the difference in you from the rest of the world. I can't tell you how many times in my life that I felt that and I've had that happen to me. I would walk by somebody in a store, not even knowing them, and they would come to me and they would say, you're a minister, aren't you? Oh, let me tell you something. If you have the love of God, they can feel the love of God. If you allow him to be everything to you, amen, they can feel that when they're with you or they're around you. Hallelujah. There's something that emanates out from you that touches them, that moves them. You know what it is? It's the love of Christ. The same one that's constraining you wants to constrain them. The one that's bound you up wants to bind them up. It wants to pull Can't tell you. Here a while back, it's been a good while, probably a year now. My wife and I were sitting in IHOP one night. I think maybe Josh and Kim's, I don't remember. They were with us, somebody was with us, maybe. I don't remember. Maybe it's been us. We're sitting there just eating. Not paying attention, just talking among ourselves. And all of a sudden, a lady sitting a couple booths over. We're just about done with our meal. She gets up and she comes to us. Now, let me tell you something. The restaurant was full. If you would have took a poll in that restaurant, if you had went table to table and asked them, are you a Christian? I can promise you, nearly everybody in that restaurant would have said, I am. No matter what they look like. Maybe a gal sitting there on a halter top and cut off so short. One preacher said they're short shorts with their cuff rolled up. But they claim to be Christian. You know? But out of all that restaurant full of folks, that woman came to us and she said, I know you guys are Christian. Whew. She didn't say, are you guys Christian? She said, I know you guys are Christian. I could feel it from y'all. Ooh, hallelujah. Let me tell you something. When his love has wrapped you up, I'm here to tell you, when his love has bound you, amen, it will emanate out from you. People can feel it around you. You don't have to announce that I'm a Christian. You don't have, come on, hear me tonight. Amen. You don't have to be anything different, amen, from what you normally look. Just walk into the world and they know you, not by the way you dress necessarily, but by what they feel from you. Hallelujah. They do know you by your dress, yeah. But you know what? Mormons dress like you do, some of them. Amen. Holy. But they don't feel nothing from them. But I want you to know this morning that his love has wrapped you up and bound you to him. I've given this example before, but I'll give it again. We're in Lufkin one day. We live there for a while. Good old mom raised her kids there in the city of Wells, right outside of Lufkin. I've been working, I was all painting, sweaty. I've been out painting billboards and I was sweaty. And my wife called me, she said, I'm up at the mall, would you like to come meet with me? I said, yeah. Went too far from the mall, so I got out on my scaffold and I ran up there. We were going to get a Chick-fil-A, so I left her a Chick-fil-A. I had to run back out the truck and get something. I'm walking down the mall, just in dirty work clothes. I mean, I wasn't looking like a preacher. I wasn't looking like anything but an old dirty worker. Nobody could tell. I had on a 3/4 sleeve t-shirt. Amen. And I don't wear short sleeves. God convicted me years ago of that. And that's my first conviction. Okay? There's nothing in the Word about that. But oh, he said, be holy. And so that was a conviction God put in me years ago. So I've got this 3/4 sleeve t-shirt on, and it's got paint all over. My britches have got paint all over them because I'm painting billboards, and I'm sloppy. Amen. And I'm all sweaty, nasty. Walking back down the mall, and all of a sudden this couple is walking on the other side of the mall, curved across the mall. I saw them, I thought, well, they were going to a store. I just kept walking. All of a sudden, somebody caught up with me from behind. The lady said, sir, can we talk to you? Sure. There's something about you that's different. Yeah, I got paint on my clothes. There's kids that pay high dollars for these clothes. Because they're all speckled with different colors. And that's what I'm thinking to myself. She said, We could feel something from you when you walk by. And then she began to tell me, her and her husband began to relate some situations in their life. And she said, would you mind praying for us? Let me tell you something. You can make a difference. Work for Lowe's. I'm up in the Lowe's store one day, minding my own business, not goofing off. I didn't goof off on the 10 o'clock. I'm at my desk. I'm working cabinets. I'm a cabinet specialist in and out. I'm working my cabinet desk, and I'm sitting there, and this guy walks or drives through on his own. Motorized wheelchair thing. And he drives past my cabinet department. Drives on over into appliances and over into plumbing. I'm just sitting here minding my own business. All of a sudden, I look and that wheelchair makes a U-turn and he comes straight back to me. There's tears in his eyes. And he looked at me and he said, sir, I don't know you. He said, but I felt drawn to you. I said, okay. He said, are you a preacher? I said, yes, sir. And he starts telling me all this trouble that his son's having and all the situation that was there in his son's life. And he said, I would appreciate it if you would pray for my son. And so I said, sir, let's pray now. So I took him by the hand and I started praying. As soon as I did, the Holy Ghost came in. Boom. It shook that man. He was literally shaking under the power of the Holy Ghost. Tears are running down his face. And I looked at him and I said, God said he's going to heal your prostate cancer. Boom. Hallelujah. Amen. A plus. But you know what it was? It wasn't me. It was the love of God that had me wrapped up to such a degree. Amen. When you get him so wrapped up in you that he is your every thought. Amen. That when you're going through your work day, you're trying your best to keep your mind on your job, but you can't because your mind's on Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, the scripture just keeps rolling in your head. There's songs on your lip that you're singing to him. Why? Because you love him. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Jesus.
Now, I never claimed to be a singer. You know, this is private. So if I want y'all to tell this, I'll let you know. Amen. But I like to sing love songs to my wife. I know some of you want to know, well, that's mushy. Well, I've done it for 38 years, so I guess I'll keep doing it. Mushy or no mushy. Amen. Simply because I love her to such a degree that I'll sing love songs to her. Amen. Crazy stuff. You probably wouldn't even sing, but I do. I just love her. And I find myself, when I'm alone with him, driving down the highway, and all of a sudden, without even thinking about it, I just begin to sing a love song to him. I don't sing a song like him, I sing to my wife. Amen. But I just sing a song to him and let him know how much he means to me. Jesus, you're the center of my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you. All the rest of that song, I don't remember it all right now. But when I'm under the inspiration, I can sing the whole song to him. And I just drive along, and there's been days. This needs to happen in your life. There's been days that I would be just driving along and just singing to him, and tears would just be flowing down my face as his presence came into my cab or my truck. Amen. Knowing that I love him, knowing that the love that he has for me is going back and radiating back to him. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, somebody. Amen. God loved you enough that he wrapped you up with his love. Are you so wrapped up in him this morning that you'll give it back to him? Are you so wrapped up in him?